Wow, Rob here giving a response and review. Jerry Sandusky found guilty. My God, thank God, friends. Justice was served. You know, I get a little nervous on some of this stuff sometimes. Like OJ was, I don't know if he, it seemed like, you know, some of these other cats were totally just gun smoke in the dead body and they got off. So there was way too much evidence against this guy. I don't know what could possess a person like that to do what he did to all these young boys. One boy overall, you know, dozens and dozens of times. You know, the only thing I could think of, he was seduced and possessed by spirits of lust of, I don't know, it's just absolutely crazy. I really pray in my heart that all these victims have the grace of God to forgive Mr. Sandusky for what he's done and put them through all the years of the abuse. And the only, you know, God hasn't called us to forgive the action of the person that hurt us or wounded us. He's called us to forgive the person. Do you ever see in the news some woman has to go to the jail and face the murderer of the person that murdered her, you know, some the mother's son or her husband? Because if you don't forgive other people of what they've done for you, God can't forgive you of what you've done to him. Now, again, you forgive the person, God will deal with the action. You know, how can you say, well, Rob, you kidding me? Those victims are supposed to forgive Jerry Sandusky. If they don't, they're putting themselves in their own spiritual prison. They're going to end up in bitterness, in rage, in hatred. And unforgiveness will block a free flow of God from their own life and relationship with God. And you may say, oh, it's unforgivable, it's terrible, it's absolutely horrific. I'm certainly not condoning what Jerry Sandusky did. And, you know, again, God will deal with him. He's being served justice on this side of the earth and probably in the world to come, my friends. You know, man, it's terrible, man. The guy's a football coach at a major, and he's doing this. He's ploying these kids' showers. Oh, my God, it's absolutely crazy. Hey, by the way, I'm a minister of the gospel, friends. You can subscribe to my ministry channel via YouTube. Also under the search, Rob Wood 1. I've got many other Christian preaching, teaching, ministry videos via YouTube where I talk about the Bible, Christianity, heaven, hell, angels, demons, unforgiveness, and forgiveness. Again, I'm not condoning what Jerry Sandusky did. It was absolutely beyond animalistic. It was one of the most horrific things I've heard in a while. But the point I'm trying to make is that those victims have got to forgive. Now, the reality is hurt people hurt. And the people that can hurt you are the people that are closest to you. So we've got to release and forgive people so we can now be free to go on with our life and experience the healing, the grace, mercy, compassion, love, kindness of God. Hey, I'll leave you with this. John chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son that if you'd believe in Jesus, friends, you'd not perish, you'd have everlasting life. The Lord desires everybody to have everlasting life. He desires no one to perish. The only way to have the assurance and insurance you'll make heaven your home is by having Christ in your heart. Say this simple prayer. It may say, Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Thank you for being my Lord and Savior. If there's anybody that's hurt you, just say, Lord, I forgive, and put the person's name, Joe. Lord, I forgive my mom, my dad, my uncle, my neighbor, Lord, I forgive them. Give me the grace to go on to freedom. I forgive them, and Lord, I release them into your hands. Thank you, friends. God bless you. If you want to subscribe to my ministry channel, go for it. Be blessed. The Lord loves you.